Hello everyone. Today we are going to create contour line with Global Mapper based on digital terrain model, and we are also going to see several options within this program. First, you open Global Mapper and you navigate to your location with an orthophoto or with a shape file. Once your Global Mapper is oriented, you need to find the digital terrain model of this area. You can find several digital terrain models online. You need to connect to online data and terrain data. You find after GDEM, SRTM 1 arc second and SRTM 3 arc second. But be aware, all those available digital terrain models are not of a very good quality. Therefore, we are going to use a digital terrain model done previously with a drone, which is much more precise. We drag the imagery over the digital terrain model. At this point, you can make the analysis. You click on Analysis, Generate Contours. On the top, you have the space where you can put the name of the layer that you want to create. In this case, we are going to make contour line of 1 meter equidistance. Therefore, I will write 1 meter. Below, you have to write the equidistance, 1 meter. You can also choose feet if you want. In this number, you have to write the resolution. We will see later how this number will influence the quality of your contour line. Below, you have several options. Interpolate to fill small gaps in data, that's a good option to click. If you want to append the label, the meters on your elevation, you have to click on this icon. This option, Create Spot Elevation Point, is important if you want to identify all the peaks on your area. Peaks may be important if you need to install elevated water reservoir, and depression or low point are important for drainage. If your digital terrain model is too big, you can limitate the analysis on clicking on the top on contour bound, and here all data visible on the screen. Doing like that, the analysis will be limited to the area visible on the screen. At this point, the contour line has been generated and a new layer has been created. This layer is built by several layers, and you can split it in doing following. You select the layer, you right click on the layer, you go down to layer and split into separate layers based on attribute value. You click OK. And then you will see that several layers are generated. In this way, you can extract detailed information of your contours. You will have major lines, you will have minor line, you will have maximum elevation, and as well minimum elevation. Each of these layers can be exported for further use in GIS or CAD. Here you can see all the spot elevation. Since we have used a high resolution, we have many spot elevation. And here we can see the lowest point of our area. At this point, we create again the contour line, but we are changing the resolution. We will do do it with a very low resolution, and let's compare the difference. I change the name of the layer. I call it contour line 1 meter low resolution, and I change the number on the box for the resolution. I click OK, and the new layer is created. At this point, we can compare the two different layers, low resolution and high resolution, and you can easily see the difference. This is now the point where you have to estimate or to judge which one suits best to your need. You can split the new layer, you select it, you right click the new layer, you go to layer, you go to split, and you click OK. Several new layers are created, and as before, you have a minor contour line, maximum elevation, minimum elevation, and so on. Let's compare the layer with maximum elevation. The layer with low resolution shows few peaks, while the layer with high resolution shows many peaks. As usually, you can export each single layer for further use in GIS or CAD.